Welcome to the Chief Architect Seminar. In this session, we're going to cover how to create interactive 3D viewer models and share them with your clients and subcontractors. This session's chief challenge that accompanies this video is to create a 3D viewer model and share it on Facebook or Instagram using the hashtag Chief Challenge. More detailed information about the challenge can be found on the Chief Talk forum under the announcement section, and we look forward to seeing your results. We're going to start off the seminar by taking a look at the 3D viewer and getting an understanding for what it is. We will then jump into Chief Architect and take a look at how you can create these models and then how you can share them through your online account. Then we will take a deeper dive into the 3D viewer app. So let's get started. So here I am in the 3D viewer app, which is Chief Architect's free app for sharing Chief Architect models directly with clients or subcontractors. Once you've created a model in Chief Architect and are ready to present it to your clients, you can export the model out of Chief, email the client a link to the model, the client clicks on the link, and they can start viewing your designs. This allows the client to view the design in their own home without you having to make any trip out to their home. The client can view the model in either a web browser or the free mobile app for the Google Play or Apple App Store. The app has controls to allow the client to navigate through the model similar to how you would in the 3D model in Chief Architect. You can also send specific saved cameras or notes and include those in the model to highlight specific details. The app also has interactive virtual reality features for physically walking through the model and seeing what views looking out windows may look like to help give the client a first-person experience of what the space will feel like and really visualize the design. A little bit later in the video, we will take a look at the app's features in more detail. But next, let's jump into Chief and take a look at the process of creating a 3D viewer model and sharing it with others. So here I am in Chief Architect, where I have a plan completed that I'm ready to send it to the client. For this plan, we have a kitchen design with an adjacent living area, a deck, and then a few other rooms. You'll also notice that this plan has a saved camera, and we'll talk about the saved camera here in a little bit. But the first step in creating a 3D viewer model is creating a 3D view. So to do that, I'm going to go up to our camera options, and I'm going to select the full camera, which is like a first-person point of view, and then just click and point where I would like my camera to face. Now that I'm in a 3D view, there are a few things to consider when exporting 3D viewer models. First, if we take a look at this cabinet next to the sink and open up the drawer, you can see that this drawer is a trash pullout. I'm going to go ahead and close the drawer, but you will notice that I've placed a note on this cabinet indicating that the cabinet contains a trash pullout, and we will include this note when we export the 3D viewer model. Next, you want to make sure your 3D viewer file size is reasonable by minimizing the surface count and texture size. Every 3D object you see is made up of numerous flat surfaces to render the model. If we rotate in 3D, you can see my model has over 400,000 surfaces in the bottom toolbar, which is a reasonable amount. If we select on this chair, you can open up this symbol and see that this chair is made up of almost 2,000 surfaces. This is a rather low number of surfaces. However, if we select on the appliance in the corner and open up the symbol, you can see that the appliance has over 32,000 surfaces, which is a much bigger number. An optimal file size will have around 500,000 surfaces. So if you are exceeding this number, you can minimize the surface count by either deleting objects or by turning off the layer that objects are on. If you are exporting 3D viewer models regularly, you may consider adding a 3D viewer layer set to your template plan that has unnecessary layers turned off. If we open up the active layer display options on the right hand side, you can see that I have a layer set titled 3D Viewer, which has certain accessory and framing layers turned off. You can create your own 3D Viewer layer set by pressing this Copy Set button, give the layer set a name, and then turn on or off the desired layers. I'm going to go ahead and cancel out of this, but once you've made the layer set and ideally have completed the plan, you can save this plan as a template plan so that any future plans you create include this layer set. You can save this plan as a template by going back to your floor plan view, going to File, Template, and then Save as Template. Next, when exporting 3D viewer models, you can export saved cameras so the client is positioned in front of specific scenes. To save a camera, go to the View drop-down and select Edit Active Camera. From here, you can give the camera a name, check Save, and one thing I like to do is set the camera's height at a realistic first-person point of view. So I'm going to change this to 72 inches. Now that the camera is set up, you are ready to export the model. When exporting the model, you are exporting the active layer set. So if you have set up a specific 3D viewer layer set, now is the time to activate it. Additionally, we are sending this model to our client, so we're going to send the full design to the client, but you can also set up layer sets that expose details you would like to share with subcontractors. For example, if you look at my layer sets, there's one for 3D framing that maybe would get shared with the framing contractor. This is just another great way the 3D viewer can be used to help make sure all parties involved are communicating on the design and construction requirements. For this example, we're going to switch back to our 3D camera layer set, and next to export the 3D viewer model, go to File, Export, Export 3D viewer model. From here, you will need to log into your Chief Architect account, and this is the same account you use to manage your software license. Next, you can either create a new 3D viewer model or replace an existing model. The replace existing model option would typically be used if you had already sent the model to the client, they provided you with feedback, you had made revisions to the design, and you want your client to view the most up-to-date version of the design. I'm going to go ahead and choose create a new model. Next, you can give the model a new name and description. Below you can see your surface count and texture size. And on the right hand side you have options to include cameras or nodes. If you click on cameras, you can see that saved camera I had by the entryway, and I'm going to check to include it. And then we also have this new camera by the kitchen that we have included, and this is going to be our camera that the client sees as their initial view when they open the model. Next, if we click on notes, you can opt to include any notes that you've created. Once you are ready to export, click on OK and the export process will begin. Once the export process completes, you will get a confirmation message and you can click on this link to be redirected to Chief Architect's website and sign into your online account. Once signed in, you will see this option that says Manage 3D Viewer Models. Here you can see the model that we just made, and you can click on View to start viewing it immediately in a web browser if you are viewing the model on a desktop or laptop. Once the model loads, you will notice that the model is missing textures. Over on the left-hand side, you will want to go to the option that says Rendering Techniques and change the rendering style from basic to standard to turn on the textures. Next, you'll notice there's joysticks in the bottom corners to maneuver through the design. We aren't going to look at the controls in the web version of the 3D viewer, as the mobile app will have the same controls and more. Let's go ahead and close out of the model, and we will look at it again in a bit on the mobile app. But next, if you want to share the model with someone, click on the Make Public button. This will bring up two more options, Share and Make Private. If we click on Share, a menu pops up with a few different sharing options. The first will display a direct link to view the model, which you can share in an email, on Facebook, a messaging program, or elsewhere. The second option is email. If you select this option, it will display a template email that has instructions for the end viewer on how to view the model. If you click on Send Email, it will open up your default email provider on your computer with the email pre-populated, or you can copy the email and paste it into a web-based email service. And then the last option is embed, where you can take the source code for the 3D viewer model and pass it off to whoever manages your website, and they can embed the web version of the 3D viewer model directly into your website. Once you have shared the 3D viewer model with a client, they can click on the link, and if they clicked on the link while they're on their desktop or laptop, it'll open up the model in a new web browser and they can start viewing it how we were just viewing it a minute ago. If they clicked on the link from a tablet or a phone, the link will prompt them to download the free 3D Viewer app, and then they can start viewing the model in the mobile app, which has some more advanced navigation and virtual reality features. And we'll take a look at the app here in a little bit, but let's go ahead and close this dialog. And one other thing worth mentioning is that if you want to revoke the client's access to the model, you can click on this option for Make Private, and it'll halt the sharing of the model. You can have up to 99 active 3D viewer models in your Chief Architect account at any given time. And if you're getting close to exceeding this number, you can click on this deactivate button and it'll move this model from the active model section to the inactive model section. So that's going to be how you can share 3D viewer models through your online Chief Architect account. Next, let's open up the mobile app and take a look at some of the navigation and virtual reality features that are available to the client. So here I am in the 3D Viewer mobile app on a tablet. Once the app loads, you will see options for viewing models on the left-hand side. If you are not meeting the client in person and you have provided the client with a share link, from their mobile device, once they tap on the link and download the app, your model will appear underneath the shared section of the menu. Alternatively, if you are going to be presenting the model to the client in person, you can log into your Chief Architect account and under the saved section, you will have all the models in your Chief Architect account available to view. So I'm going to tap on saved, where you can see I have three models in my online account. From here, I'm going to download the model we just exported. And once downloaded, you can then open or delete the model. I'm going to tap on the open button. Once the model is opened, you will notice that my initial scene that I am seeing is that camera scene we exported from Chief on the desktop. You will notice our screen space is partially taken up by the sidebar on the left-hand side. We can maximize our screen space by closing the sidebar by swiping off the screen or by tapping the circle with the arrow in it. Now that we have more room to maneuver, you will notice that I have joysticks and controls around my design. The joystick on the right allows you to look around the design. And the joystick on the left allows you to move around the design. Using a combination of these two joysticks, you can maneuver throughout the model. As we maneuver around this design, you can see that note that we exported from Chief, and you can view the note text by tapping on the note once. By tapping anywhere in the design, you can close the note. You will also notice there are controls around the joysticks. Next to the joysticks on the left-hand side, there are arrows pointing up and down, which allow you to move your camera height up or down. You will also notice that there are buttons over the joysticks. The first button over the joystick on the left-hand side is the dynamic camera height. This allows your camera's height to dynamically change as you move throughout the design, which can help you fly through different vantage points in the model or simulate real-world actions, such as walking up or down a flight of stairs. The next button I want to review is the first button over the joystick on the right-hand side. This button turns on your device's gyro so that now by physically looking around with your device, your vantage point will look around in the model. The next button I want to talk about is the second button over the joystick on the left-hand side. This turns on the walkthrough model feature, and now by physically walking in the real world, you will walk through the virtual model. When combined with a camera gyro, these virtual reality navigation features create a fun, immersive experience for the client to firsthand visualize and understand your design. And the last option is the second button over the joystick on the right-hand side. This button turns on the background camera and inserts your real-world surroundings as a backdrop. This is a great feature for if your client is doing a new build or remodel, so you can show the client what views out windows throughout the home will look like. Next, in the bottom toolbar, there are different viewing modes. I've been viewing our model from our first person point of view, but you can also view the model from a floor plan view, an overview, or an augmented reality view. Here I am in the floor plan view, and you'll notice that there are controls on either side of the screen for viewing the floor plan at various floor levels or at specific heights. Here I am in the overview, and by using one finger you can maneuver around the design, or by using two fingers you can zoom in and out of the design. If you open up the sidebar, there's also a cross-section slider just like in Chief to view inside the model from various angles. There's also an augmented reality mode where you can attach the 3D model to a real-world surface such as a table, countertop, floor, or a large flat lot and explore around the model in detail by rotating, zooming, or walking around. In the sidebar, if we get out of the cross-section slider and go back to the main menu, there's an option for cameras. Here is where you can view the saved cameras you had set up in Chief, and you can tap on these cameras to fly into the scene. This is a great way that as the designer, you are making sure the client visualizes certain aspects of the design. If we go to the rendering techniques option, here's where you can adjust your rendering techniques to see various details of the design. The other rendering technique worth noting is the glass house option. Here you can see through objects to see various details as to what is going on inside of objects. For example, with our trash pullout, we would be able to see these details inside of the cabinet. And lastly, there's a settings panel, which I encourage you to explore as it allows the viewer to fine-tune miscellaneous settings for viewing the design. And that's going to conclude this video. As we wrap up, I wanted to remind you that there are a lot of free learning resources available to help you become more productive in Chief Architect. Additionally, the 3D Viewer app is a free app, so I encourage you to download it, view the sample plans that come with it, and see how you can use the app to help your clients and subcontractors visualize your Chief Architect designs. For this week's Chief Challenge, we want to see your 3D Viewer models. Once you export a model, post the share link to Facebook and Instagram using the hashtag ChiefChallenge to be entered to win some Chief Architect gear. More information on the Chief Challenge is available on the forum, and we look forward to seeing your models.